Today, I will start with the next module that is a function. It's a kind of function. We can call it a recursion or recursive function. Last time, we have talked about the function and how to write a function in C programming. And it's when we talk about C functions, it's like we want to split the main program or the whole program into a smaller module, right? It is like a top-down design. That is, we will split or subdivide the problem into many sub-problems. And sometimes the sub-problems can be treated as a function. We can think about the function like the function in mathematics. Think about when you were studying mathematics in high school, right? We are talking about the function f(g), right? F(g) means the function of g in terms of f function, right? Something like that. But in computer science, right, if you want to write a program and you want to think about it as a function, you can think about it as a function. Like for example, if you want to find a square root of 2, you may have to write square root parentheses 2. And this name, square root, okay, maybe we'll start from the square root if you want to write a square root function. Sorry. Okay, maybe you want to find root, square root 2, right? It can be written as a function. This is a function name, right? You may be familiar with this, and this is we call argument, right? In this term, we have just only one argument in this function, right? This is function name. This is what we have studied in the previous class, right? Last week, right? In the main function, you may call like this, root 2, right? And you have to maybe to assign it to into a value, right? A value, right? Value, right? This is a square root 2. And this one we call argument or actual parameter. Why do we call it as a factual parameter? Because it has been assigned into this argument as the actual parameters. And this one, we have to define what we call formal function. Okay, it should be written it as a float root, and maybe you just want to assign it only for integer value, integer number. This one we call actual parameters because you need to assign the real value or the exact value here, right? It could be constant or the variable. It's not a problem, but in main in function declaration, we can call this as a function declaration, right? Declaration, this one will be called as a formal parameters instead. Okay. Different place, like this one we call actual parameters. When we pass it to this one, we call number as a formal parameters. When we call root in main function, right, it will invoke this function, and two will be bound to this value. So it means that two will be bound to a variable number here. Okay, we are not going to use the aside. Right. We are not going to use the word assignment. We have to use the word binding, bound, right, to be bound. We be bound to this number, and you can use this number as a two, right, as a constant two that is bound into the number. So this is the context that we have already studied last week, right? But today we are going to think about the function in different way. This we call the recursive function or the recursion. We can use these two terms interchangeably, okay? Recursion or recursive function. Okay, first of all, I would like to ask you whether you have already studied about the recursion or math induction in discrete mathematics, in this discrete math by Ajahn Narimon. Have you studied about the terms math induction? Mathematic induction. Have you studied? Hello, everyone?
Not yet, Ajahn.
Not yet? Yes. It seems like for the lecture program and the health data side, they have already studied about this one. Okay, maybe that's not the problem. I will talk about this, review about this in this class. Sorry, I have a call. Okay, I'm back. Okay. Before we will study about the recursive function, maybe you have to know a bit about the math induction. What can I do? Okay, let me start from here. The factorial is a good example of how to use the math induction. Okay, please forget about the thing that I have written in this page, right? The math induction is like this. If you have known for, if you want to find a value from a function, for example, if you want to find a factorial. Factorial of, let's say, 5. Or we can write it in terms of the exclamation mark like this, right? So 5 factorial or factorial 5, like a function, right? It could be thinking, it could be thought like a math induction like this. For math induction, we have to start from the base case. What does it mean by the base case? The base case means the first case or the termination case of the function that we are talking about. For example, if we talk about 5 factorial, right? The base case will be 1. 1 factorial, what is the value of 1 factorial? 1 factorial is 1, right? Actually, the base case could be sometimes we can think about the base case. 0 factorial is also equal to 1 as well. Am I right? So the base case is 1 factorial is equal to 1. And inductive step. Normally, we will write it as a basis step. Or the base case, basis step, right? The inductive step means if we want to find n factorial, right? N factorial will be equal to n multiplied by n minus 1 factorial. And for the math induction, if we want to find n plus 1 factorial, right, it must be equal to n plus 1 multiplied by n factorial. Actually, the things that I have written in terms of the purple, the violet pens, right? They will be the fact that you will have to assume, or this will be the assumption of this math induction. But we want to prove that n plus 1 factorial is equal to n plus 1, okay, and then n factorial. But we have known in advance that n factorial is equal to n multiplied by n minus 1 factorial, right? This one, this term we can find it. This term n plus 1, we can also find it. So this one is finite element, this finite value. So this value could be found. So we can prove that this one is correct. If we can prove this one is correct, so we have to say that this is correct, or this is a tautology that this formula n plus 1 factorial is equal to n plus 1 multiplied by n factorial. So in computer programming or even in C programming, you can also use the math function or math induction, mathematic induction for the recursive function. This one we can call math induction. Okay, you will study about this in the discrete mathematics by Dr. Narimon again. Okay, so today I just want to review you a bit about what does it mean by the math induction. And if you don't even know about the math induction, you can know how to write the recursive function. That's not a problem. So, but before we go to the factorial function, I have to start from the recursive function. What does it mean by a recursive function? Recursive function is a function that calls itself. This is a keyword, call itself. What does it mean by call itself? So when we write n factorial, and n factorial can be written in terms of n multiplied by n minus 1 factorial. N minus 1 factorial is call itself. Okay, do you get the point? Itself means if you define n factorial, right? And it can be written in terms of the smaller itself, of itself, right? Called itself. So we can call these kinds of function as a recursion. That calls itself either directly or indirectly. So from this example, this is an example of how to write a recursive function, right? So I can split into two parts. The part one is the caller in main program caller. And this one will be callee, double E, right? In sub program. So the program will start from the main function, right? And this one, I is a value, is a variable that will get the result from recursion function, right? And this recursion function will have n as a actual parameter. And in this example, n is equal to 5, right? So 5 will be assigned to n, or will be bound to n. And n, which is 5, will be bound to the n inside the formal parameter recursion here. This one is formal parameter. 5 will be bound to n here. And then check for n. N is equal to 5, which is not equal to 1, right? So if you turn 5 multiplied by 5 minus 1, this is 4, right? And then recursion will call itself. It will bound, n will be bound to 4 instead, and then it will be 5 multiplied by, okay, this one is such an example, right? So anyone in this room will know what is the result, of this recursion. What is the result of this function or this recursion function means? What does this mean? Or what is the result after we call this function? Nope. It's not factorial, Natcha. Let's see this 5. Just 20? No. It's not that 5 multiplied by 4. 25? No. No, not 120. 600. How come? Pong, how come this is a 600? Nope, it is not 5 multiplied by 4 multiplied by 3 multiplied by 2 multiplied by 5, no. Okay, in order to check for this, right? That's why Pontagon, I think, and Paponpat and Pontagon is correct, right? I'm not sure whether 3125 is equal to 5 raised to the power 5 or not. 5 raised to the power 5 is equal to 3125. I'm going to use my calculator. If you have the calculator in your hands, please try to compute the result for this. But this function will calculate for 5 raised to the power 5 or 5 raised to the power n. Okay, so how comes, right? We have to start from this, right? The first we bound this one in with 5 and 5 we go to this. So then 5, the result will return 5 multiplied by recursion of 4, right? Because it is n minus 1. So the first step, you can get 5 multiplied by recursion. I use the abbreviation of recursion, okay? I just use R, 5 by 4. And then you have to bound 4 to here. And then it will be 5 multiplied by 3. So you can get R4 is equal to 5 multiplied by R3. And then R3 will equal to 5 multiplied by R2. And then R2 is 5 multiplied by R1. And what is R1? Once you come to n is equal to 2 minus 1 is 1, and this is 1, 1 substitute to 1. If n is 1 is equal to 1, then return 5. So this one will be R1 will be equal to 5. So this is the reason, and then it will return, right? After you get return 5 here, okay? Return 5 will substitute to R1 perform the previous stage of perform the previous function, which is recursion R1. So recursion R1 in the back will be equal to 5, and then 5 will substitute to here. So you will have 25 here. 25 will substitute to recursion 2, and then you will get 125, right? 125 will be R3. R3 multiplied by 5, which will be 625. Okay, and then the result will be return 5 multiplied by R4, right? R4 is 625 multiplied by 5. So the result will be 3125. 3125 will be the recursion of 5 here. So 3125 will be substitute to recursion here. And the last step is I will equal to 3125. And that's all. Do you get the point? If not, maybe this example is a bit difficult, right? I want to check for someone who are experts in function or C programming. So I will ask someone, so someone will know, someone will not, right? That's not the problem. You may have to understand, try to gradually understand it. So I will teach you step by step. So before we will go to the factorial function, I would like to show you the simpler function. Okay, so I will start from can you still listening to me, right? Okay, I will share screen. Okay. Can you see my screen?
Yes.
Okay. This one is the program, that right? The program template that you might have to see, right? So for example, this one I would like to write a program for summation. I will write it as a summation like this. What does it mean by summation? Summation is a summation, like for example, I from 1 to 10, right? So you are going to plus 1, plus 2, plus 3, plus 4, blah, 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 to plus 10, right? So this is the meaning of the summation function. And you may have to write the program purpose or the name of the program. Like in this example, you want to write a summation. Okay, in C program, maybe you write summation.c, right? So, this one is the format that I suggest you to write in every program that you submit to us, right? To me, okay? And the second one, you may have to show the purpose, yes? Did you turn off your microphone?
Oh, sorry.
File summation of from 1 to a number, right? If I want to find a summation from 1 to a number, right? And you are the authors, you may write the name, right? Your name and surname. Okay, so this is compulsory. You have to write it, right, and your ID. Okay, and then you will start from the include standard.io.h, right? And this is the main function. Normally, if you want to write a function for finding the summation, first of all, you may have to, start from integer sum, right, and I, sum and num. Okay, number, right? And then sum is equal to, maybe you start from summation num, right? From 1 to num, okay? And then, okay, in this way, I will assign it, initialize it to 5, right? I want to find the summation from 1 to 5. Okay, and then print out PRIT. If the summation of summation from 1 to number, right, is minus 5d. Minus mean we want to write a number with left justified. Left justified. And then this is the num and sum. Right? Okay, so if you don't know about the recursive function, you may have to write a program integer, right? This is the return value summation. Am I right? Integer number, okay? And then what should I do? I will have to start from integer I and then I do for loop. For I is equal to 1, am I right? And then I form I is less than or equal to number. And then I plus plus. Okay. And then sum. Maybe I have to define a sum, right? Sum will be the result. We have to return the value of sum, right? So I write return sum. Don't forget to return something. Okay, this is when I write the program, right? I try to show you about the idea or the correct steps of the program writing, right? When you write a integer summation, which is the data type of this function is integer. So first of all, I would like you to write, don't forget to type return something. Maybe you have to write integer and result like this. Okay, normally when I write a program, I will write result. No matter it is a sum or the factorial or Fibonacci, or it is a function, I always like it as a result, right? And then result. I do this because I don't want to forget. I don't want to forget to return something, right? For the integer return type function. Okay, so in this way, I will, okay, result. Okay, I will use result. Result is equal to result plus I, right? Because I would like to find the summation of I, right? I from 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 until number, right? And I will add them up into the result. Am I correct? It seems to be correct. But the most important thing is that if you define a result variable, a result variable, you have to initialize it. What is the value that I write to initialize it for the result? What is an initialized value? Result is equal to please type it. Okay, 0, right? It is 0, right? Because it is the identity for summation, for sum, right? It is an identity for sum, right? So we have to start from the 0, okay? So this one is a good example of how to write a summation function using iteration. Okay, when we use for loop, right, it is a kind of iteration. What does it mean by iteration? Iteration is the other name of loop. This is another name of loop. So we can call this as an iteration or iterative function. Okay. A function that we use as an iteration, we use iteration. Okay, so I will run it and the result is supposed to be ,15. Okay, the summation from 1 to 5 is 15, that's it correct, right? And if I would like to change to maybe to 100, right? I write it and I then run. Okay, it is 5050. So it's correct. there's no problem with this function. But the thing is that today we would like to show you about how to write a function in terms of the recursive function. So I will rewrite this into the integer and summation or recursion, recursive sum. Recursive sum is the summation function that we will use the recursive. Okay, and then I do the same thing, right? I use number. Okay. In this case, right, we are going to write a recursive sum, right? So what is the basis step? Basis step is very easy. The basis step is what is the basis step? When number is equal to 1, right? If number is equal to 1, what is the result of 1, the summation of 1? The summation of 1 is 1, right? The summation of 1 is 1, right? And then else will be the inductive step. Inductive or recursive step. Inductive step. Inductive step means return what? Return number, right? Plus recursive sum of 4. Oh, no, right, of if it is 5, so we return of 4, that is a number minus 1, right? Just this, it's very simple, right? You can see that if you use a recursive sum, right? If you know about the math induction of the summation. So it's pretty easy, right? To write a program. So first of all, you have to write the in basis step, right? If, or sometimes I called it as a termination step. Termination step. In or ending step. Right. This is the step that you will end up your program, right, with. So one is sound. We use the end number is one to be the stopping step. And then, right, you just simply use the, okay, it's number, right? Number will equal to itself, right? But minus one, right? We don't know in advance. Suppose you want to find the summation of 5, right? But you know summation of 4. So the result will be 5 plus recursion of 4 and so on. You don't have to think about it. You don't have to know how to calculate for the summation of 4. You can use the recursive function or call itself until the number is equal to 1, and then you can get the result. So let me change this one to summation, recursive sum. So when I run it, the result will be the same. Okay, do you get the point? Easy, right? Don't think about it too much, right? It's very easy. So if I would like to change this function to find the factorial, so it's very simple. So I have changed it. So I use the factorial. recursive factorial. Okay, so what shall we do? So for the recursive factorial, I can just simply change this one to just only change plus to multiply. Multiply, right? So, okay, I cannot use num as the 100, right? It will be overflow, but I will use 10 instead, and then I run recursive sum. So I have to change it to recursive factorial. Okay, maybe I have to change it to factorial. Why not? I use the factorial. Okay, and then I run. Is this a result from, this is the result of 10 factorial. What is minus 4, minus 5D? That is a good question. Normally when we use 5D, so it will be right justify. Do you know the word right justify? Justify that. So it will be close to the dot. Okay, this is 5, you cannot see it. So I use 10, okay? So we will reserve the space for 10 columns, and then write that is fine. But in opposite, right? If I use minus 10, it will be left justified. Left justified. So it will be close to the left-hand side one. Okay. Okay, you can see that this one will be close to reserve the space for 10 characters, and then we'll left justify, and then the rest will have to put the space before you put the full stop right after this one. Did you get the point? I want to show minus or no minus, right? I want to show you the right justify and left justify. Okay, if you want to change this summation into the iterative function for the factorial, I can just simply change this to multiply, or I can use multiply equal. Am I right? And what is the initialization of the result here? Is it still zero? You have to use the identity of multiplication. That is one. Thank you, Natcha. You can write the answer to everyone as well. You don't have to use the direct message to me. Okay, I can change this to one. Okay, and this can be the iterative function for the factorial. Okay, maybe I use fact. Maybe I have to change this to factorial. This function is worked for the small number of num here. But if I change it to 20, do you think the result is still correct? No, it's round up. Why the result is minus? It's a negative number. Anyone in this room can tell me? The range of integer, that's right. The range of integer is limited, right? When we're trying to find the value of 20 factorial, it will be overflow. We can say it as a overflow, right? And it will, the result can be round up into the negative number. So in order to solve this problem, what shall we do? So the first thing that you might have to correct in this program is that you cannot find the factorial of the negative number. So you have to use unsigned that integer number, okay? Unsigned that integer number, okay? So you have to make sure that your result is not the negative number, because the negative number, you cannot find the negative number because the induction step will be minus recursively and until the number is one. But below one, right? Like zero or negative number, the result cannot be solved for the factorial function. So you may have to protect this function by using unsigned integer. So this is the next concept that you might have to know. And the result, not just only integer, you may have to use long integer. Long integer, and then the sum will have to be long. Sum. Okay, this dot sum, you have to change it to factorial. Okay, I will try to run it. Long integer. And this one, D is, oops. D should be LD. Okay, this is a result of 20 factorial. 2, 4, 3, 2, 9. Okay, this is a correct answer. Change in integer to long in, that's right. Mm-hmm. Change the data type, thank you very much for your answer. Okay, that's good. So what we have learned from this example, from this program, the first thing is that if you want to pass the value, the variable of the factorial, you need to know, you have to make sure that this is not the negative number. So you have to use unsigned integer. Okay, that is the first thing. The second thing is that if you think the value of factorial is very big, right, you may have to use long int or long integer in order to keep the 8 byte long integer for the long integer. So that's all. Up to this point, do you have any question? Okay, if you don't have any question, right, please feel, or if you can have some question later, you can ask me later, okay? So now I will give you a short 10 minute break, and then we'll come back again, okay?